On to the ongoing Senate probe into government's pandemic spending, the Senate Blue Ribbon Committee approves a motion to make public the income tax returns of those involved in government's allegedly anomalous pandemic supply deals. Among those cited are several executives of Farmily, former presidential advisor Michael Yang, and Zuzu Construction Machinery Group.
President Duterte is always telling the public that hirap na hirap ang pamahalaan, wala pong pambayad, kaya po yung ayuda ay hindi po nabibigay. Yun pong pambili ng bakuna, 45 billion, eh nasa ang program fund. Ibig sabihin, walang pundo doon po sa 45 billion para sa pambili ng bakuna. Ay hindi po pa tama lamang. Natingnan natin doon po sa magandang mga kontrata na nakuha ng lahat na suppliers, 42 billion. Magkano bang binayad nilang income tax? Apart from the overpricing, apart from unqualified suppliers being given the contract, apart from the preference to foreign suppliers, I think it is incumbent upon this committee to look into the taxes paid by these suppliers.
Meanwhile, two key officials of Farmily, Mohit and Twinkle Dergani, are no-show during Thursday's Senate hearing. That's despite a contempt order over their refusal to hand over subpoena documents on the firm's transactions. Last week, the Senate panel was unsuccessful in arresting the siblings, who were allegedly not in their registered addresses. The Kusi wing of the ruling party PDP Laban urges President Rodrigo Duterte to run for senator in next year's elections. Energy Secretary Alfonso Kusi says he believes President Duterte can bring change to the country at the upper chamber.
Mapapasok po natin si Pangulong Duterte sa Senado, eh mamumuno po siya sa pagsusulong ng structural changes po, including pagbabago po ng mga maamendahan ang ating constitution, opening our country to foreign investments, no po. Mapapag-usapan na rin po yan, ano? Katulad po yung sinasabi nga po ba natin, will the foreigners be allowed to buy land, no, or own land in the country? So yun yung mga bagay na ganyan maisulong na natin kung paano po tayo. Masyado na po tayong behind sa ating mga neighbors.
But for the rival PDP faction, this move is an act of desperation. Senator Coco Pimentel says it seems like Kusi and his group are totally depending on Duterte's popularity and strength of personality because they don't have strong candidates. Senator Manny Pacquiao maintains he is not backing out from the presidential race. Pacquiao says sliding down as a vice presidential or a senatorial candidate is not an option. His remark comes after Senator Aimee Marcos said Pacquiao is among those eyed by her brother, presidential aspirant Ferdinand Bongbong Marcos Jr., as a possible running mate. Pacquiao has been vocal about his opposition to the atrocities committed under martial law. The Commission on Elections gearing up to mount debates for the 2022 elections. COMELEC spokesperson James Jimenez says presidential and vice presidential bets will each face off in three debates starting in February. The candidates will participate in person, but the audience will only get to watch the debates online in light of the pandemic.
Yung mga kandidato magkakaharap-harap pa rin in the same place, in person. And besides, hindi naman ho siguro maganda o kaaya-aya yung debating online na pare-pareho tayo naghihintay na matapos kang magsalita, no? Or baka biglang nawala yung kandidato kasi nasira yung connection niya. Tatanggalin po natin yung live audience kasi yung live audience, yun ang pinaka-at risk sa sakit.
Jimenez adds they will also release debate guidelines for private organizers. Taking money from politicians, then voting based on your conscience is easier said than done. That's according to one assistant professor from the University of California, who published a study on the issue of vote buying back in 2018. Ceci Cruz says they discovered most of those who take the money tend to actually vote for the candidate who gave it. She adds some of the voters in provinces are even afraid of possible reprisals.
Vast majority of people, when they accept money, they do vote for the person. And what they tell me is that it's not, sometimes it's not even because they're afraid of the politicians, but it's utang na loob, you know, we feel obligated. We feel like that's the expectation. It's not just a matter of telling voters, oh, you know, it's not a big deal. You just accept the money and then you can vote for whoever you want. Because that works in some places, but in Isabela, for example, in some places in other provinces, we've seen politicians, even sometimes jokingly, you know, they'll say, oh, hindi mo naman ako binoto, or you didn't vote for me. And those types of things where even if not said in a threatening manner, I think people can be very fearful of those types of interactions, especially since for most Filipinos, our mayor or our local politicians, those are the people we go to for help. And so the idea that if you're afraid that you cannot approach the mayor, right, if you didn't vote for the mayor, then that's a very big reprisal already.
The Catholic Church has suspended a priest in the Bicol region. The reason? He is running for mayor of Libmanan Town in Camarines Sur. Father Granville Pitapit says he has seen the dismal situation of their town and he knows he can make a difference. Libmanan has a 47% poverty rate. He adds running for public office will allow him to implement reforms that will uplift the lives of his constituents.
The solution is already clear to the, is already there for the problem, and yet the weak point in this tripod of development, like private sector, CSO, and then the government. So the local government is the weak point. I sense that if there is a voice from the people, there is a voice from God. So I have to discern it well. Mm. So with those situations and with my background here, so it comes to the point that there comes a final decision that I'm willing to go into another kind of public of service, not anymore inside the church, the institutional church, serving the spiritual needs of the people, but more on the concrete and real needs of the people right now.